Thank you. Thank you. going on with it. Okay, it looks like we've cleared the storm now. We have a strong tailwind behind us, making a really, really fast flying now. Actually, we're flying over Sumatra now. Take a look outside your window at the amazing landscape. Did you know that Indonesia contains the world's third largest area of rainforest? These rainforests are fully spectacular. I am so lucky.
Ha ha! know how it's in the way.
Filho, vamos embora. Vamos embora, vais andar sempre com a mãe agora.
Que está quase a fechar, anda. Vamos ver outros.
Está bem, eu deixei isso, vamos ver com ele.
A cheeky smile from a cheeky seal. Everyone, let's give Cisco and Kate Marie a big wave goodbye. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you.
kangaroo up on the left.
Thank you.
Excited, huh? Jump, look. Big stretch.
Get rid of that.
When they were 8 weeks old, so we spoke to dog trainers and previous dingo keepers to make sure their lives are super positive. Hi! So it seems like they're quite food motivated today, but it's not always like this. So often they'll just kind of ignore what I ask them to do, but right now you can see she's actually trying to put her nose in my pocket, so we'll see if she'll sit for me. Where to sit? Like, it depends on what you're offering. I'll think about it. A lot of things is up to them to choose. They don't sort of strictly obey what I'm asking them to do. It's sort of more like a coexistence, I think. A relationship, I guess. I found if we sort of tell them what to do, then they are less likely to do what we're asking. What a station. I might not have anything that high value on me either. Okay, station. Okay, that's fine. Then you won't get the snacks, that's all. Well, I've forgotten what I was saying. Okay. Right, dingoes are cool. Okay. And thank you for listening. Oh, that's not what I asked. I know. Oh, now he's sitting. Oh, it's very cute. Maybe how about you sit here? Station. Sit. There we go. Yay, good boy. Well done. You can see how lean they are as well. So this leanness, this is just their choice. Obviously, we give them a lot of food, but they're kind of like an athlete, I guess. They want to be able to race and hunt kangaroos and be agile as possible. So even people that have pet dingoes find that they often don't eat every single day. They often turn down a lot of food, and they're very fussy about the type of food that we're offering as well. I forgot what I was going to say, I'm sorry. Has anyone got any dingo questions? I'm impressed that you all stood there in the rain and everything. Thank you for listening. And is anyone here doing the dingo encounter today? I've heard we sold two tickets today. Alright, I'll be around if you have questions. Otherwise, thank you for coming.
If you meet a dingo in the wild, what do you do?
I did. That's where I was going with my story, and I forgot. If you see a dingo in the wild, please don't see them as a super friendly skinny dog that needs feeding. Please see them as a miniature wolf. They're cute, yes. Even in the wild, they're cute. But I would never feed a wild dingo. So the minute you feed any wild animal, you change your relationship with them. They can lose their fear of humans, and then they can become very curious, playful, and maybe even aggressive. So unfortunately, Fraser Island is the most famous place that has dingoes and also has tourists. No,
now feed dingoes, you see one in the wild.
They generally should be afraid of people. That's normally what their nature is like, yeah. Except, of course, our two, which have been born in the zoo. Good question, thank you. Any other questions? I'll turn off the mic, but I'll be here, yes. Ah, so they eat
pretty much a strictly raw meat diet. They're unable to process much fat at all, and they can't process starches either. So lots of kangaroo. Chicken. Yeah. Yeah. I know. And even then they turn up their nose sometimes, yeah. Quite fussy. I'll turn off the mic bad. Thank you guys for listening. Thank you.
Thank you.
No worries.
Oh yes, thank you. Yes. So yeah, when we walk them every morning, so they see, you know, we've got those turkeys, the wild turkeys, they want to chase them, but we try not to let them get excited. We try to focus back on us so they calm. But if one was in here, yeah, then she'd be chasing. The instinct is very strong. Oh, thanks everyone! What was that? Oh, their age? Or to live to? I've heard it's like a middle-sized dog, so maybe like 14. But I think they can live up to like 20 or something, you know, in a stable environment like a zoo or, you know, someone's home or something.
The other one is over here. This one is over here.
Thank you. Thank you. say to you already?
I'm food. So I'm very sorry. No food, no food. This girl's a very cranky girl. Put a bit of palace in. This is in the back, lots of them, so we try to put in with it. And she won't have any friends. All she wants to do is fight. As soon as you put them in, we think, oh, you know, she'd like a friend. No. She's been like that for years.
How old is she?
I don't know. She's one of the oldest around. I think, yeah. But he is the most venomous snake in the world. And all that means is, you can see how small his head is, it just means that he carries enough venom in his mouth that anyone can, and the venom is so strong, as they say here, he can kill 100 people. Now, of course, he doesn't bite 100 people, but if you lined up 100 people, that little snake has enough venom, and the venom is strong enough that if you gave everyone a dose of venom, it would kill them. So that makes him the most venomous snake in the world. I don't know if it's a good or bad title, but that's what it gets. Australia's got the top 20, 30 most venomous snakes. Australia's got more. We get a lot of international tourists. South America's got the worst. Australia's got the worst. We're so lucky. So don't go travelling in the middle of Australia, otherwise you're... But no one's been killed by a snake in the last 100 years, so we're pretty safe. Mind you, I had a guy, I'll tell you a quick story. We had a guy and he did inland tours, and he said, I've been doing inland tours for 27 years, and he takes anti-venom with him, and he does Central Australia, looking for animals, like snakes and stuff. So he said, I said to a guy, there is a snake there, but just stay away from it. He said, he pointed like that, and he said, the snake of all things did bite him on the back of the hand. So he said, I had anti-venom, I wasn't worried. But he said, within about 10 minutes or so, his hand was starting to... you know, seize up a bit. So, and of course it would go through into your heart and you'd be dead. So he said, we got him off to hospital pretty quick. I thought, well, it wouldn't. He said, oh, it took about 10 minutes. He said, for the venom to start working. Now, of course it would have to work. If you put a tourniquet on, well, and he had the anti-venom. So he said he never died, he didn't have any ill effects. But no, so you've got to... You've got to be a bit careful, but as I said, he's never had a problem. You always get one person once they've had a snake. I know,
that's right. Oh, thanks for telling us that.
Okay, yeah. No problem.
Sorry.
Okay.
Okay.
See you.
Yeah.
too young now, so. Thank you. Yes.